touch Jesus and be healed? Do you sometimes wish Jesus had healed your loved one? Do you wish that Jesus had brought somebody you knew back from the dead? Do you wish that Jesus could heal you from your pain and anxiety? What do you wish and hope for? At our diocese and convention this year, our Bishop Eugene Sutton sang All Shall Be Well. This song he sang throughout our convention. And I thought it was an interesting one given the year that we have had as a diocese. But he sang it with passion and conviction that all shall be well. And it reminded me of a song a pastor and a songwriter wrote, You Are Holy, by Meg Barnhouse. This song is a dialogue between her and the mystic Julian of Norwich, who wrote those words, All shall be well, and all shall be well, and in all manner of things, all shall be well. And in this song, You Are Holy, the dialogue goes, Julian, do you not know sorrow, pain, loneliness, disease, and cruelty? How can you say the words, all shall be well? For sorrow, pain, loneliness, disease, and cruelty have brought me to my knees. And Julian's reply is, who does not know sorrow, pain, loneliness, disease, or cruelty? And it's because of that Julian went on her knees and said, all shall be well, and all shall be well, and in all manner of things shall be well. And Julian's response was, I can say that because I have known tenderness, friendship, the spirit, and the love that never ends. So what have we got in our hearts and our souls that we are wishing for hope, wishing for tenderness, wishing for friendship, wishing for the spirit, and hoping for that love that never ends? And can we sing the song, All Shall Be Well? In your bulletins, you will see a little chant, All Shall Be Well, and James will play it through once, and then I will sing it, and I invite you to join in on the third time. It is because of those statistics that one of the resolutions that were passed at General Convention is to recommit ourselves to criminal justice reform and advocacy. The General Convention has encouraged each diocese and congregation to take active steps to advocate for reform. It asks us to advocate for the protection of civil rights and provisions and appropriate supports and accommodations for people with disabilities who are arrested and incarcerated. To advocate for funding for job training and apprenticeship programs for those at risk of incarceration and for those who were formerly released from prison. It has asked us to repeal the mandated minimum sentence for non-violent offences. It has asked us to join the Bound the Box campaign to remove the question about arrest records in online and written job applications. And the list goes on. We have a long way to go. But it's because we have known tenderness. It's because we know friendship. It's because we know the spirit, and it's because we have the love in our hearts that never ends. We can sing. Because they have known tenderness, because they are known friendship, because of the Spirit, because of the love that never ends. They listen.